debt calculations are commonly required in financial models or budgets and forecasts. First thing we're going to do is just go through and show that everything your financial calculator can do, Excel can do. So what we've got here is a debt profile. We've got a present value or the loan amount of 100,000. We're going to use a 12% nominal interest rate over 12 months. There's a payment of 5.7 because there's a future value or bullet residual value of 40,000. Given any four of these five items, you should always be able to work out the fifth. So for example, if we're given this bit of information and we want to know how much the loan was, there's a function in Excel called PV, which means present value. Where it works, it says what's the rate. What's important by the rate is you'll see it says it's the interest rate per period. Because this is 12 months, I need to go here and divide by 12. How many periods are we referring to? It's the 12 months. What's the payment? That's what we've calculated. What's the future value? Now you need to be careful here. When I choose that future value, you'll see Excel saying that the answer is 29,000. That's because for this calculation to work, generally the payment, the sign on the payment is the same as the sign on the future value. So we've captured this as a positive 40,000, but we need to put a negative sign in front of it to give us negative 40,000, which then gives us the correct number, 100,000. Type is whether it's beginning of period or end of period. So if we leave it blank or put a zero, it assumes end of period, which is the more common one. When I say OK, you'll see it gives me 100,000. If we want to work out the rate, so now we're given these four items as information, we want to know what the interest rate charge was. There's a function in Excel called rate. And what that does, it asks for the number of periods. I'm going to point here. What was the payment? What's the present value? What's the future value? Don't forget, it's minus whatever that number is. The type is a zero. When I say OK, you'll see it tells us 1%. That's because that's the rate per period. We've got a 12-month period, so we need to times it by 12 to get our number. If we're given this information and now we want to work out how long will it take for this to turn into that with these repayments and that interest rate, the function in Excel is called NPER, number of periods. And it's pretty much the same, the rate divided by 12, the payment, present value, future value is negative 40,000, the type is a zero, and you'll see it tells you 12 months, so it'll be 12 months to make that calculation work out. The most common calculation when it comes to debt is to work out what repayment will turn that into this. So the function in Excel is called PMT. What's the rate? It's this one here, but divide by 12. How long? What's the present value? The future value minus the 40,000. The type is zero. And when I say OK, it tells me that we need to repay 5,730. Finally, if we've got this information, we want to know what is the end, in month 12, what are we going to have outstanding. The function is called FV, standing for future value. And what it does is that's the rate, don't forget to divide by 12. The number of periods is 12. Payment is this. Present value is that. Type is zero. And notice it gives us minus 40,000. So it correctly gives us the correct sign. If we need it to show it as positive, we'd then have to multiply it by minus 1. So this shows you that Excel can do any of these functions that your financial calculator can do.